You know the insides and the outsides of these cars well. Tell us about what re-engineering is required by a car company such as GM or Ford to get ready for EVs. How do they make them differently than what they made internal combustion engine vehicles?
Anytime somebody asks us, we recommend that they go to a clean sheet type of approach. Sometimes trying to squeeze or shoehorn EV into ICE doesn't really work out well. So most of the cars that we're involved with right now, we have four vehicles that we're working on, and in all those cases, they're brand new designs. Going backwards doesn't really work. As a matter of fact, good example is the Kia Niro that we had a look at. That car can do ICE, it can do HEV and EV, and in essence, basically what you wind up with is something that isn't extraordinarily good for any of them, but you can squeeze them all in and it's not the right approach. The right approach is go EV.
So does that make a broader point about companies that are so-called pure play, like Tesla and Rivian, versus for the companies that are legacy are coming right now? You at one point were something I thought of a critic of Tesla, although I think you've come around on that. You may even have invested in the company at this point.
I did. I invested for about 8-9 months, and I made a huge amount of money. Not because of what I had to say, but because of what was happening with the short sellers and whatever. When we first got in, when we first saw the Model 3, I was horrified. I couldn't believe that anybody would turn out a product that looked like that. And then later on, we took apart a Model Y, and I was very, very impressed at the difference. Now we're waiting for the Plaid. We're going to be tearing a Plaid apart here shortly. And I'm anticipating that Plaid is going to be remarkable. And by the way, just to let everybody know, I get no free cars. I never accept anything, not even lunch from these guys. So we keep it arm's length.
That's fine. Finally, Sandy, I want to give you a chance to talk about AVs, not just EVs, but AVs, because I understand you have a viral video right now that's very popular because you're concerned about what the U.S. government is not doing at this point.
Well, I'm worried more about what they might do, and that is to slow down automated driving. I think that if what I hear is correct, and unfortunately I'm hearing it all through the press, but if what I hear is correct, I think that that they're going to put lots of people's lives in jeopardy. And I was really unhappy when I did the video that came up yesterday on Munro Live. I was very, very unhappy. I believe that the government should step aside and let technology take over. There's too much emphasis on, like for instance, battery fires and these big changes. Well, who got thrown under the bus? Well, General Motors. But it's not their problem. This is the supplier that's giving them batteries. These batteries are no good. They had to be taken out. And by the way, General Motors is only one. What happened to Kia and Hyundai? They also had to strip out all their LG batteries. I mean, really?
Well, Tesla's had a couple of battery fires as well along the way, as I recall. But does that indicate anything of the future of EVs? Are we going to have more situations like that where it's a new technology, it's not proven to scale? Yeah. Are we going to have more situations where we have to take a step back before we can go forward?
I think that what will happen is that the technologies, they're going to migrate. Yes, there were some Tesla fires. I mean, one guy ran over an anchor. Another one ran over a pickaxe or something and pierced the batteries and they caught on fire. But by the same token, David Welsh, actually with you, your organization, we had a little chat and found out that in 2018, there were over 250,000 fires that were in ICE vehicles and 200 and something or other people died. They don't seem to get the same enthusiasm, if you like. But if you have one or two fires, you get a lot of press. So I think that what we have to start looking at is this is just like when we started in the aircraft industry, just like when Henry Ford brought out his first vehicles and whatnot. We have to wait for the technology to catch up.